Introduction to Graphing Inequalities.
So now we are going to solve not an equation, but an inequality. And the inequality we're going to solve, some unknown number that when you add 5 to it, you get a new number that is less than 7. I know I haven't necessarily solved an inequality before, but something that I have solved before that looks similar to this is an equation. On the right side, I'm going to solve x plus 5 equals 7. And I'm going to see if I can use this new problem to help me solve what looks like a more challenging problem. So when solving x plus 5 equal to 7, I know there is only one answer to this problem, and the answer is 2. And the way that we can demonstrate using algebraic properties to get x by itself is we are allowed to add a negative 5 to both sides. 5 plus a negative 5 is 0, and negative 5 together, they make a 2. And so I have x equals 2. Now, if I wanted to represent this answer on a number line, so I'll go over to 2 on the number line. Right here, x equals 2 is a solution to the problem x plus 5 equals 7. So looking at my equation, I may attempt to try and solve the inequality on the left side the same exact way. And we will see if doing this method gives me the information that I've been looking for. For x plus 5 is less than 7, I'm going to go ahead and add on a negative 5 to both sides. And then I have 5 plus a negative 5 is 0. 7 plus a negative 5, that's 2. And so I have x is less than 2. When I see x is less than 2, that tells me there isn't just one answer. I'm allowed to pick any number that's less than 2 to check my original problem. So I'm going to choose 0 because I know 0 is less than 2 and see if I get a number that's less than 7. 0 plus 5 is 5. 5 is less than 7, which is true. So I can go to my number line here and I found one answer, but we're not done yet because I need to represent all of the answers. So I have to pick all the numbers that are less than 2. So not only does 0 work, negative 1 is less than 2. If I check that here, negative 1 plus 5 less than 7. Negative 1 plus 5 is 4. 4 is less than 7. That's also true. So I found a second answer. And going back to my original solution that I had, I have to shade all numbers that are less than 2. So I've shaded in a 0. I've shaded a negative 1. I've shaded in a negative 2. In other words, I have to shade in all the numbers, not just the integers. I need to shade in the 1. I need to shade in a half. I need to shade in a third. I need to shade in all of the numbers that are below 2. And I have put an arrow here to represent that my shading is going to continue on forever. As the further you move to the left, the more I need to shade. So in my equation on the right, 2 represents what's called the boundary point. In other words, it separates the right answers from the wrong answers. So here where there's a 2, I'm not going to shade in the 2 because I know 2 does not work. And why does 2 not work? Because if I'm plugging a 2 to my equation, 2 plus 5 is 7, and 7 is not less than 7, so that is false. A common way to represent the 2 as a boundary point is with an open circle. And that lets everyone know that every number below it, according to the arrow, is part of your solution. So the graph is the most accurate way to visually represent all the possible answers to an inequality.